So this week, I would like to discuss about 10 positive outcomes or 10 things that what we learn from this COVID-19 pandemic. So I think this is a really important aspect that we need to look at. We need to recognize this. Remember about in the past, in the previous videos, I talked about the ten finger. So 10 good qualities, 10 qualities within you, 9 positive, 1 negative. What we see is only negative aspect, then we exaggerate. And actually, there's 9 good things happen with you, around you, but we don't look at, we ignore. So therefore, actually these 9 good qualities are there within yourself, around you. But then we need to recognize what happened if we are not recognized those, if we are not discovered those, then even though they are there, and for you will not get so much benefit. It's almost like you are rich, but you don't know you're rich. So traditional example, 10 kilos of diamond in your house. If you don't know there's a diamond, then the diamond become same as piece of stone, you know. There's a lot of stones in my house. Maybe I should, you know, remove those. If you not recognize these diamonds. So if you recognize the diamonds, then the diamond really benefit for you. So similarly, these 9 great qualities, they are here with us, but we need to discover it. We need to recognize it. And then these good qualities will manifest you. So once these good qualities manifest for you, then you feel like you are getting something new. Actually, it's not new, it's always there. So therefore, I think I discussed in the past about the basic innate goodness. So in Buddhism, there's a lot of emphasis about the basic innate goodness or the original purity. We all have these great qualities within ourselves. And special, our true nature, the fundamental level of ourselves, is really good, wonderful. So, and what are these great qualities? The awareness, love, compassion, wisdom, skills, potentials. So many are there. So remember about how to discover these great qualities within yourself. And I gave some teachings. Even the first meditation technique, when we watch the breath, and for us special, our lineage of this meditation is main focus to the subject, the awareness. So knowing breath is the beginning of wisdom. And at the same time, you allow whatever state of your mind, state, whatever state of your mind, you can allow all these good things, bad things, confusions, clarities, dull, hate, love, whatever, allowing. And that is the great kind, actually. Great love, no hate. If you try to block, that's aversion. And actually, we are learning how to discover. Because for the fundamental level, with the awareness, this is all like cloud. Positive cloud, look like good cloud, beautiful cloud, or ugly cloud, not nice cloud. It's all same in the sky. It cannot be polluted. Your nature cannot be polluted. Always present, pure, Wonderful. So therefore, these good qualities are actually manifest many different ways in your life here and there. Actually, every moment now. And then, knowing is awareness, recognizing is wisdom, allowing is love and compassion. All these are there, but we are not recognized. We have to discover step by step. Even with the, let's say, hatred. When you look at really, go to the bottom of hatred, there's love. Hatred is a manifestation of love. So why hate? Because something is, you feel something is wrong. You don't want to have something not good, unsafe, unfair. So you try to, you know, block them. But then how block them? We are influenced by ignorance. Then our skill might be not connected with wisdom, not connected with the wisdom. And we too tight become hatred. But the basic level is love. So every moment, every breath, every thought, these great qualities within us is manifesting. So these are the through the meditation we can discover those, but there's another way, another kind of like meditation, we can discover these great qualities within ourselves. So that is what we call appreciation. Through appreciation, through gratitude. So, as I mentioned before, if, let's say, 10 qualities, 9 is positive, 1 negative. I will not see 1 negative. I want to see 9 positive. I want to see 9 positive. I want to see 9 positive. Will that be beneficial or not? Very difficult. Remember, our mind does the opposite. I need to recognize. But I need to recognize. No. Don't think about negative. Don't think. Oh, I think of negative. No. Big problem. You know, this teacher said, don't think about negative. Negative will bring another negative. Then you will be more negative. Entire world will be negative. So this way, it doesn't work. So now how to do it? Another way is, one way is awareness. And this way is appreciation, right? New one. So appreciation meaning try to see whatever happened. Looks like big, bad. Like now it's a pandemic or a lot of disasters happen. But when you look at it a different way, wow, there's a lot of great things happening there. One time I heard a story that there's a mother and a daughter. And in America, I was there. There's a lot of kind of like gang fighting. And then I think one person killed a few people. So the mother was really upset and really not happy and looking at the television. And then the mother was complaining. Wow, the world is really bad now. Is everybody crazy? Every day world is getting worse and worse, you know. And then daughter said, Mom, yes, one person did bad things, but see, many people are helping. See, many people are trying to, you know, do a lot of good things. There's a lot of people who helping around there, a lot of generosity, a lot of support. And the mom was, she told me, she was shocked. Wow, this young daughter. And she said that's the one of the best kind of the teaching for her. So similarly, whatever happened, there's a lot of good things there at the same time. And we need to appreciate that. We need to acknowledge that. We need to recognize. Then when we do that, then we will grow, really transform. We will have real transformation, real growth. And these things are, you don't need to do like, I need to achieve this. You just discover it. So when you discover the diamonds in your house, then diamond really benefit. And that time you feel like you get new diamond. Actually, not new diamond. Diamonds are there with you all the time. So, normally I tell this story sometime, you know. When I teach meditation in class, sometimes I teach for 2 hours, sometimes become 2.5 hours. And while I'm teaching, I drink a lot of water. You know, drink and then teach, drink. Then after 1 hour and half, my lower abdomen is full of water, meaning I really want to go to restroom. But I still have, you know, half hour or 1 more hour. So, although I'm teaching, but my mind is in the restroom. When I will finish? How should I finish early? So sometime I say, oh, okay, now finish. Any question? No question, good. Then suddenly people raise hand. What is the meaning of life? You know, very difficult question. And I try to give a simple answer. Sometimes simple answer lead to another complicated question. Then in the end, I say, oh, thank you, thank you. You know, now we stop here. And then in my mind is all about the restroom. So then I go to restroom and use the restroom. After finish using restroom, wow, life is so wonderful. You know? Really happy. Wow, very appreciate. So, feeling so happy. Happy to have this life. Happy to be everything. The restroom, people, so much appreciation. So, actually, most of the time, you don't have this problem, isn't it? Problem about needing to go to restroom originally. We don't have this problem. So, life is wonderful, actually, but we are not see that until we get something difficult, until we get something challenge. So, therefore, I think this pandemic also gives a lot of lessons for us. We can learn from this. We can grow from this. So today I will discover something. I mean, I will discuss something about the 10 things that outcome from here. So first, I think is a relationship, I think. So I heard of a lot of some of my students and some of my friends sending me a lot of messages that their relationship actually getting better. Of course, it's a very intense moment, and it might be some time. Of course, it's 10% of people always have some problem. Sometimes getting worse. Special now is very moment like cooking, you know, everything together, every day together. It might be relationship, some problem might happen. I heard some other stories, police get a lot of call from the relationship problem. So maybe the 10% of people sometimes might become like that. And but then many people, the relationship become more bound, genuine connection. Because normally everybody doesn't have time. Many people has a lot of to-do lists, need to follow all these to-do lists, and then maybe suddenly they have appointment, very tired work from morning 9 to 6 p.m. or whatever, 7 p.m. And then in between there's no really time connected with the family or people who you love. So now there's a lot of those time. And many of them say, oh, we are staying with our family. We are staying with my parents. And we are spending time with my kids. And then they say they learn a lot from this with kids, with the parents, with the husband and wife. So, and they try to, many people, they try to do something new at that home. They cook, they try to learn each other, try to understand. Sometimes, of course, this up and down may happen. So I think this is one of the, what I hear is a lot of good things outcome from what we learn from this is really beneficial for the relationship. And the second, what I hear is a lot of people saying about the development of spirituality. So, and this is what we call is like in our meditation tradition is called bardo. Bardo meaning in between the moment. So the transition of life, something unexpected happens. So this something unexpected happen in your life, then at the beginning, quite painful, of course. That's what we call disillusion moments, like falling or melting or losing. And that is actually really great because we all have this kind of like limitation, our kind of like cocoon of the world, our comfort zone we all have. And as long as if we stay in that comfort zone, actually we cannot really grow. We can really totally transform. I mean that it will steady, but then you're stuck there. So now with this pandemic came huge unexpected surprise. Suddenly, at the beginning there's a lot of pain, but now our mind go inward, you know. And then there's a lot of reflections, and there's a lot of the mind become automatically some what we call is first is a disillusion moment, then there's some kind of like mind become lucidity. There's a lot of flexibility there, and the old kind of like comfort zone, the habit concept is gone. New habit hasn't formed yet, and many people stay there. And then many people, actually, we all have this kind of like inner resilience, everybody. Once you get those certain unexpected surprises, we will learn so many new things. And especially, we will learn a lot about ourselves. Normally, we are busy, our mind is always going out. Now they're out, so many activities are gone, so mind inward. There's a really kind of like you going back to who you are. There's some kind of like going back to your home. So I think many people, I hear this, and this is the spirituality. It's really go inward. So that's the second, I think, thing that we learn from this. And now third is what I call self-discovery. So once you go inward, then many people, especially if you have some spirituality, and no matter what I call, accept, let it go, but don't give up. Continue transform, continue transform. Then actually, there's a lot of self-discovery, and the personal development happens. That's the what we call third stage, becoming. So first, dissolution, lucidity, then becoming something. So for me, actually, this is a really kind of like a lot of benefit. I do sessions to retreat every day, and also I learn a lot with my family, my mom, my brother, and also monastery. I'm in the Nepal, in Kathmandu, in the monastery. I learn a lot from around here. So, and then it's kind of like normally what I do is sometime I teach very busy schedule. Then I do retreat, solitary retreat. And I don't read book. I don't try to reflect any other things, just serious into meditation. But now this time more loose retreat. So it's kind of a balance. I get a lot of resting. I get a lot of self-reflections. I get a lot of kind of like learning myself. And that is really beneficial. So I think I will share in the future, slowly, slowly. Now, Number four is, I think, the health. So hygiene level. I don't know how to wash my hand before, you know. So now I know how to wash hand very well. For example, in the beginning of January, that time there's no lockdown happened that I was in Bodh Gaya. So the virus is already exists in China and some of the countries are there. It's going out. So everybody was very worried and then we learned a lot about how to wash hand, how to use the mask. And then the and normally during that time in the Bodh Gaya, India, everybody will get very serious cough and cold. Sometimes a lot of virus also like really fever and everybody when we are in the prayer, you know, if there's a little break, we will hear continuously. But this year, very less, only a few of because they did wash hands, you know, take masks and did some distance, try to clean. So whoever and they cover both mouth. So therefore, even the cough and cold doesn't spread much. So I think these are great that things that we learn, I think. And then at the same time, many people who stay in home, they really look for how to develop this immune system because COVID-19, we need to develop our immune system. We need to have a lot of vitamins balance. So many people are eating a lot of vegetables, fruit, and many people are doing physical exercise. And here in my monastery, some people they never do exercise before, you know. Some monks. And now they do exercise. They try to eat vegetables, fruit. And now they like it. When they do exercise, they feel very nice. And now they want to do exercise. The body automatically telling them, oh, I should do exercise. So they become kind of like that new habit is for me. New habit of how to take care of health and how to keep the hygiene. I think that is the number four that we learn from this pandemic. And number five is, I think, environment. So, where I'm, my place here in Kathmandu, there we have kind of a small hill, Sitapaila. I'm on the top of Sitapaila, and I can see entire Kathmandu. Kathmandu is the capital city of Nepal, the biggest city in Nepal. So in the past, I cannot see very clear, even though there's a great weather. But now, sometimes I can see mountain behind the mountain, very far. And then normally I see the mountain far. Now it's kind of like I feel it next to me, and so clean. So fresh. And I think that might happen many part of the world. You know, now pollution level go down. And here I have behind behind my room, there's a small garden, backyard, and I plant a lot of trees, different trees, herbs, trees. And now, a lot of birds comes here. Every morning when I wake up, choo, 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 you know, so many different birds. And some of the birds I never seen before. And these birds are not here. And even local people, they're surprised. Many bird, new birds are coming. So now, kind of like nature is coming back. And I think this is really nice, you know. So, and this is, I think, wonderful. And now the number six is a lot of, I think, innovations. New discovery, I think. So, I heard of that many of companies, they have to change their working style. They need to change into more, many of them do online, and many of them, the company, they allow the workers can work at home. So when they work at home, and many people, they have a lot of discovery that, wow, it's balancing very well. If they want to take a nap, they can take a nap. And then when they have energy, they can do work very clear. And they can do a lot of things. And they need to walk, they walk nearby there. Walk, you know, do some exercise. And have conversation with the family. And then do some work. So I think there's a lot of new ways. And also one many company I heard of that, they teach a lot of things. So that I will tell more later. So I think in the past whenever we have this big pandemic, there's a lot of, after that, a lot of new kind of like innovations came in our human history. Yeah, so I think that is the, will be the, and still is continuing, and I hope we will have a lot of great innovations with this current pandemic, and it will benefit for us, humanity, in the future. And number seven, I think there's a lot of, so one obviously is we all, many people are looking for vaccine, new treatment. So in the past, like World War I, World War II, those war in the world, you know, a lot of fightings. And people learn from that. Now world become peaceful, actually. There's one scientific study show that at this moment, the world is really become peaceful, that entire human history, right now, the most peaceful time in the entire human history. Because in the past, people are fighting each other. And if you don't like each other, maybe just boom, shoot, you know. There's a lot of fightings, gangs, robberies, wars, so many things. So now the world is become actually more peaceful because we learn, actually, we grow from there. But at the same time, normally what we say is world, we feel like world is getting worse, world is, you know, not peaceful. And that is why, because of the one negative, you know, nine positive, one negative. And then we exaggerate the negative. We deny the nine positive. So nine positive doesn't have so much power, so much power. When we look at the televisions, sometimes there's a lot of good news, and what do we think? Yeah, yeah, of course, yeah, that's normal. And if there's the bad news, bragging news, you know, even you're drinking coffee, you know, we get attention, bad news. So therefore, I heard of a lot of the news, media, they look for bad news. Why is that? Because good news are common. We think, of course, yes, this is normal. Nothing which is unique. But bad news become unique. The bad news are uncommon, not common. So then people get attention, you know? Like in our brain, this is what neuroscience told me, that brain is something new detector, something unusual, something surprise, suddenly detect. So therefore, bad news is unusual. So it can detect our attention. So therefore, actually it's a good sign. We can detect the bad news, a good sign. Few years back here in Nepal, we have a lot of political problem. So at that time, a lot of the robberies, lockdown, curfew, no light, no water, no oil, no gas. It's very, very tough time. So every day there's a bad news, and people up to a certain level, they don't really look at the bad news. Something good news. Oh yeah, really? So people look at when the good news comes, everybody really big open eyes, you know. So when we in the news, or not only in the, I'm not only saying in the media, but in friends' conversation, in the people. So whatever we surprised with the bad, because of actually it's a good sign that bad things are uncommon. So, but anyway, at the same time, we learn a lot of this, and I hope right now the world is become peaceful. My point is we learn a lot of a past mistake, past war. So now I think the next, our worry is this small invisible war. So there's a virus, I think, for the humanity. One of the big challenge for us, this virus. And this is not, I heard of this, not just one virus. There's thousands of the different virus are there. It may transmit to the human. So I think hopefully from this we can find a lot of learning for our health, how to take care of our health, how to find the new solution with this challenge, invisible challenge, invisible challenger for us. So I think this is already processing now, and it might have great lesson for entire humanity, this invisible, some people say this invisible enemy. So this is 7. And 8 is, I think, what I call resilient. So all this until 7, when we see, actually there's a lot of resilient develop when they have unexpected problems, challenge comes. And we look for new solution. We will go out of our comfort zone. We will go out of our cocoon. So, and another very important thing is we accept this, and but don't give up. Continue to learn, continue to transform. I think this is really important. So, normally, my father When I was young, my father told me that how to discover our basic innate goodness. Three ways. One is through learning, study. So education is very important. Second is experience, doing. If you do something, now don't think too much, just start it, and then you will surprise. Wow, I never thought of that. It happened. Good result. I never thought of that. I have that skill. I never thought of that. It will may happen like that. So normally if you do something, most of the time there's some result. There's a fruition. There's a good result. Of course, sometimes may go wrong, of course. So then we grow, we learn, we discover from doing, from experience. And then number three thing is the problem. It's the challenge. It's the obstacle. So when we face this, then there's a big problem. I mean the big progress. When we have big problem, then we will progress, develop a lot. So this is, I think, resilient will develop this. So I think this is very important to understand these things and to really important is don't give the hope. Don't give up. Let it go. Let it go meaning letting go is not giving up, accepting. So don't give up. Continue to learn. Continue to transform. So that's a really will develop resilience, I think. And number nine is the meditation, I think. So now everybody stay at home. And many people, nothing, not too many things to do. And then look at on the online and watch my video, you know. I'm just kidding. So there's a lot of teachings nowadays online. And these teachings with the meditation, a different style of meditation. And many people, they do meditation sessions every day in the morning, in the evening. And I do that for myself. And really, really beneficial. So meditation is really beneficial during those challenge time. So one way, the meditation is very soft and it's really invisible. But when you have big challenge thing come, very strong. And sometimes you may surprise. Wow. When I learned meditation, and if I face this kind of situation, I'm totally crazy in that time. You know, I'm totally angry. I'm totally upset. But now, you know, I didn't cry or I didn't become crazy in that moment. You may surprise. So these are really kind of like power of benefit of the meditation. And last, number 10, is education. A lot of. So for me, I learn a lot here. I read them. All the texts that I really want to read this for. I finished my study now 3 or 4 years before. After that, I didn't read much. For 20 years, I every time wanting to read. And I also learning sometime online, watch different classes. And I'm learning a lot with the nature here, farm, vegetables, trees, flowers, bamboo, and how to cook. And in my monastery, I'm teaching meditation. Me and my brother, we are teaching. And then we learn each other a lot. We have a lot of Q&A. And actually, it's really learning. So many people, they sometimes stay at home. They learn a lot of classes. So this time is a great learning process. And I heard of that in the In the past, 1916, they have big pandemic like this, isn't it? 1655, 1655, around that time. And then in England, there's a scientist called Isaac Newton, and he was in Oxford, and Oxford University closed that time due to the pandemic. Now closed, not just this time, that time also. And he went to the kind of like self quarantine, some kind of like that. And he said that's the best time in his life. He really discovered a lot during those time. And also Harvard University, the who started Harvard University. He was from England, and he lost his business, and he sell his real estate and went to America and start Harvard University due to this pandemic. So there's a lot of about these things. They learn a lot, and all these things happen from this pandemic. So I think what we do now is this is just general list, and your personal level, it might have a lot of things happening, positive happening around you, about you, and relationship between you and your friends and family. So we should do one appreciation meditation. So we will do this appreciation meditation together. So please keep your spine loosely straight and relax your body, your mind, breathing naturally. And first, appreciate that you have this body right now, and you are breathing. This is wonderful. Appreciate that you are breathing. Appreciate that you are alive. Wonderful. Appreciate that you can hear me. You are hearing this teaching. Not only the teaching, you have this wonderful ear, you can hear the sound. And appreciate that today I'm watching this video and learning something wonderful. Appreciate that you are stay with this meditation posture and with the silence. This is wonderful. And this is one of the reasons is the pandemic. Due to this pandemic, I'm learning, I'm growing, wonderful. And then the rest, you can see what the positive things happen and that happen, and whatever things that you learn from this pandemic, and to appreciate those. Now please open your eyes. Appreciate that you have eyes, and appreciate that you can see. Okay, so try to practice this. You can write also, maybe 10. Might be difficult. Five appreciation about five things. And with this pandemic or in general, At the beginning, it might be difficult, not easy to find those five things to appreciate. And slowly, you will have a lot. But if you find a lot, don't write too much in one day. Then you cannot continue next day. Stay 3 to 5 first. And then if you have a lot, then if you have a lot of things to appreciate, you can change one day about you, one day about relationship, one day about family, one day about the world, one day about different situation. So you can change. And that will be creative something. Creativity and changing something new way to appreciate also will be really beneficial. And then wish that this, although I discuss this things that what we learn from this and this pandemic, but we all pray that soon this pandemic will end and then world will become peaceful again. Thank you.